In a previous video on insulation resistance, we looked at the conductors that need to be present and connected in order to carry out that test correctly. It threw up some questions in the comments and I'm trying to answer them in this video. We're going to answer what happens to insulation resistance when conductors get longer, as well as why would we be linking together live conductors and testing them to the protective conductor and not individually testing line to CPC and neutral to CPC, and we'll see if that test where you link them together is more onerous than doing it individually. So let's consider what's happening to insulation resistance test when the circuit gets longer. So first of all, I've got my conductors exposed here as if I was carrying out the test. I've got my line and neutral, and we know that the copper conductors are covered in thermoplastic PVC. PVC stands for polyvinyl chloride. And we know they're a great insulator. They're not absolutely perfect, but they are a fantastic insulator of the conductors. So if we come over to here and we're just looking at those two conductors, we've got a line and we've got a neutral insulated throughout the cable, and there is a massive amount of resistance between these. In our first test that we carry out, the continuity of CPC, we're looking for a circuit, a complete circuit. In the insulation resistance test, you're looking for lack of continuity. In other words, we wouldn't expect, with all loads removed, the line connection to be connected to the neutral connection, because if it was connected together when you turned it on, it would obviously go bang. So we're looking for lack of continuity here. So in other words, because these are insulated, there must be a massive resistance between these two conductors, and we're measuring our insulation resistance, and often we see on the machine greater than the machine can read because the resistive value is so high. So if we put that resistor in, so if I bring it in, I put it as, say, 1 billion ohms of resistance. So that resistor between there is 1 billion ohms. Our machine wouldn't read that high, but it isn't perfect, okay? The insulating material around these is not perfect, but it's going to be absolutely fantastic. So that's our first cable there. We measure between live conductors, and we get a reading off the machine, but if we could read it, let's say it was 1 billion ohms of resistance. Fantastically high value. Now that conductor is of this length. If we add the same amount of conductor in again, so if I bring this one down here, so I've added the same amount of conductor in again. So I bring that into circuit, I bring it in like so, and I've now doubled its length. So I've doubled the length of that cable. The first part of the cable, when we measured its insulation resistance, say was a billion ohms. I've brought exactly the same cable in of exactly the same length. So what value of resistance would you expect this to be here? Okay, I'm sure you're thinking, hopefully like I did, another billion ohms of resistance. And that is correct, and they are connected in parallel. So it's going to link back to our electrical science and principles as well. So let's bring that resistive value in between here and here. We've got another resistor at 1 billion ohms, and they're connected in parallel. So 1 billion ohms of resistance there and 1 billion here. So they're connected in parallel. They're both of the same value. So if we were to draw that circuit, we would have one resistor connected to another resistor of the same value. Okay, and let's just put them down as 1 billion. They're connected in parallel. There's two resistors of the same value connected in parallel, hopefully from our electrical science and principles or the videos I've produced on these. We know when they're both the same and they're connected in parallel, it's half the value of one resistor. So actually, the overall insulation resistance now would be 0.5 of a billion ohms of resistance. So let's go back here. We've got this one connected in parallel with this one of the same value. We've doubled the length. But what's happened to the insulation resistance? We've actually halved the insulation resistance. We're down to half a billion ohms of resistance. It's a massive number. So we can say a couple of things. We can say that when we do our insulation resistance test, we're looking for a lack of continuity, so conductors aren't connected together. We expect the value of resistance to be super high, even though we know PVC is not a perfect insulator. And we know that if we double the length of the cable, we actually halve its resistance. So longer circuits have lower insulation resistance than shorter circuits because of the opportunities for the insulating material, which is fantastic, but not perfect, to actually leak across. So we got our insulation resistance test for longer conductors will be lower than shorter conductors because of that. And they're really key points as you move through your training. So we go back and think about that next test, insulation resistance, where I suggested it should be live conductors together to the protective conductor. We know that the protective conductor must be connected to the earth terminal, and all our protective bonding, the earthing conductor and the source earth from the installation need to be in place when doing this test. So I couldn't actually carry out an insulation resistance test with it off the board like this. This CPC here would need to be connected to the earth bar, and we covered that in a previous video. But let's think about it. If we did just the test between line and CPC, and then we did a separate test between the neutral and CPC, we can see from our previous, imagine the resistance in here was 1 billion ohms when we tested between those two. And then when we tested between these two, we also got 1 billion ohms. Okay, so that would be our insulation resistance test. But it asks you to link together your live conductors. So in other words, we should have our line and neutral linked together and test them linked together to our protective conductor. So all of a sudden then, the resistance that's in here and the resistance in here are in play at the same time. If we said again that they were 1 billion ohms for both of them, of the resistors, we can now see that we've got this one and this one connected at the same time you carry out the test. It won't be 1 billion for the overall insulation resistance because you've got the two connections together, exactly the same as we did before. They're connected together at this end as we do our insulation resistance test, so you get the two effectively in parallel. So by connecting live conductors together and testing them to the protective conductor, it's a more onerous test because this conductor here is tested to the protective conductor and this conductor here is tested to the protective conductor at the same time. So when we do individually tests between, say, line and CPC, record our reading, and test between neutral and CPC, separately, we're only doing part of the test, but when we bring the two together, all of this insulation material around the two live conductors, neutral and line, are tested at the same time to the CPC. More conductors in circuit mean more opportunity for the insulating material to leak across to the protective conductor. And we know that obviously the length has doubled because we've got now the neutral and the line connection together to the protective conductor than we did when we did it individually. So therefore, by testing the live conductors together to the protective conductor, it's a more onerous test on the installation and has more conductor in circuit. More conductor means the overall insulation resistance test would be lower. We also suggested that this CPC needs to be connected into the earth terminal within the consumer unit where the protective bonding is, where the earthing conductor is, and the earthing conductor needs to connect into the source earth. So if this insulation resistance test on this cable here and there was a pipe adjacent to it, what you've got to remember is that these would be connected together inside of the connection within the consumer unit. So the earth metalwork would be connected to the earth bar of the consumer unit where the CPC is connected. So now all of a sudden when we carry out our insulation resistance test, we're actually carrying it out to any metal work as well. So this part here also gets tested. So in other words, as you bring the cable in, we're testing it between the conductors to the protective conductor and any earth metalwork. It could be this cable is under a floor, very close to a metal pipe. The metal pipe is connected to the protective bonding, back to the earth terminal, back to the source earth. You'd actually be testing the insulation between the live connections in here as well to the earth metalwork as well as the CPC. So that's why we must make sure our CPC is connected to our earth bar, because our earth bar then connects to all our metalwork within the installation, and the insulation resistance test would test the live conductors to the earth of the system. Okay, in other words, this metal pipe and the CPC would be tested at the same time. Might take a little bit of thinking on that one in order to get it round so you understand what's going on there, especially in your early training. If we didn't and we just checked between our CPC disconnected from our board and our line connection, we can see how that's a lot easier test for the cable to put up with than when we link together our live conductors to our CPC and bring in all our bonded metalwork and test between those live connections to everything that's connected to earth. So hopefully that's added to our understanding a little bit more about the insulation resistance test. We can hopefully now clearly see the longer the cable, the more opportunity when carrying out the test for it to leak, maybe between live conductors. And as we add more and more cable, actually will lower the insulation resistance, whether we see it or not on our instrument. And hopefully we now understand that when we link together our live conductors and test them to our protective conductor, we've got more cable in circuit, more conductors mean that that is a lower insulation resistance test than carrying out individually. I know on site often we do, say, line CPC, neutral CPC as our insulation resistance test. But if we put the two together, we've obviously doubled the length of live conductors, therefore we will lower the insulation resistance. And also we've seen the fact that any earth metal work adjacent to the wiring system will be tested during that insulation resistance test, as long as our CPC is connected into our earth bar, where all our bonding's in place to our gas, water and oil, as well as the earthing conductor that goes to the source earth as well is in place. We'll check and test on those as well. But as always, I hope this video has been some help.